Yeah, welcome to submarineboat.com and another night testing hydrophones. This is David Bartsch.
I'm Doug Jackson. This is my wife, Kay.
And what we've got is a great improvement. We put the conductors from the hydrophone into a 3/8 inch airline, and now very little sound by knocking on the airline. You can hear it, but not nearly what you did before. The other thing is the unit has a our speaker system hooked up to it, and the two set systems are isolated a little bit with that orange quarter inch airline stuck over the quarter inch bolts. And we're still using our little guitar amplifier, and there's our sound making system, the amplifier for the microphone there, and the noise you're hearing is water running into the hot tub. So we're going to turn that off and see what we get.
Alright, put it back to high gain.
Yeah. Undo it. There you go. Okay, we're not going to be able to test this, the pumping sound into the water, because we don't have the way right now that when you key the mic, we're going to have to be able to cut off the hydrophone, so the hydrophone amp is still connected. And the deal is, here, also, David committed to putting four of the piezo discs in there, and they're all tied together, so we think this system is at least a lot more redundant, and it's definitely just as sensitive. The other thing that's different here is we're not using plexiglass anymore. The piezo discs are adhered with super glue to a 1/16 inch sheet of aluminum 7 inches by 7 inches square. And then behind that is a 3/16 inch sheet of aluminum. And between the two is a section of, I think it's 4 inch PVC coupler that like an inch and a half thick. And then the speaker system that we worked on yesterday is there. So when the mic is rigged up, this thing is the talk and listen side. We just got to get the mic to key one out. You get two of these things, you can talk 500 feet.